Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial. And in this tutorial, we will be implementing a solution of one of the another frequently asked Java interview question, that is reverse vowels. So let's get started. So in this program, we will have input of any random string which we will be using to transform it into output. So how we will be transforming that input into output using reverse vowels logic, let's discuss that. So we will be taking a help of a two pointer approach. The first pointer is a left pointer, which we are usually calling it as left index, and the second pointer we have a right pointer, and we are denoting that with right index. Initially, left index will be pointing to the zeroth index of array, and right index will be pointing to the last index of array. So here we will have four use case to handle. So let's write down those four use cases. The first one is left index character if it is vowel, and right index character itself is vowels. In this case, we have to do the swap operation. We have to swap left index vowel to right index vowel, and right index vowel to left index vowel. If the left index and right index both are holding any vowel character, this is our first use case. The second one is when only left index holding the vowel, like right index is pointing to any consonant character, but left index is pointing to any vowel character. In this case, we have to freeze the left index and we have to decrease the right index. So left index will remain as it is, and right index will be decreased by one. The third use case is when right index is pointing to any vowel character, but left index is not pointing to vowel, it is pointing to consonant. In such case, we have to basically freeze the right index and we have to increase the left index so that it can search for any vowel towards the right hand side. Left index plus plus. And the fourth use case we have, when left index and right index, these both index are pointing to, is not equal to vowels character. In such case, we have to increase left index by one, because both of the pointer is not pointing to any vowels, both are pointing to consonant. In such case, we have to increase the left pointer so that it can check towards the right hand side, and right pointer we have to decrease it by one so that it can start moving towards the left hand side. So these are the four use cases we have to handle. Now initially our index value will be zero, and it will be pointing to zeroth index of array, that is L. So L is not a vowel, it's consonant, and right index is pointing to last character of array, which is E. E is basically a vowel. So we will be freezing this right index and we will be increasing left index. In this case, this use case is true. So we have to increase the left index by one, like this. Okay. Now we will be again checking whether left index is equal to vowels, or if it is vowel and right index is vowel or not. If both are vowel, so this condition is true, we have to do the swap operation. So right index will be swapped with the left index, and left index swapped with the right index. Now after that, here we have to increase left index and right index because the swapping is done. After performing the swap operation, we have to increase left and right, both of the pointers. So let's increase left by 1 and decrease right by 1. Alright. Now we will be checking whether left index is holding any vowel character. Yes, it is holding, but right index is not holding because D is consonant. In such case, left index will be freezed and we will be decreasing right index. So this use case is true in this case. So we will be decreasing right index by 1. So now you can see left is pointing to vowel and right index is also pointing to vowel. O is vowel only. So we will be swapping both of them. In this case, this condition is true. So let's swap this. E will be swapped with O. So here it will be E and here it will be O. Once the swap is done, we'll be increasing left index by 1 and decreasing right index by 1. So let's do that. Okay, and decrease right index by 1. Now we will be comparing whether left index is holding any vowel character. No. Right index is holding any vowel character. No. It is C. So this last condition is true because left index and right index is not holding any of the vowel character. In such case, we will be increasing left index by 1 and decreasing right index by 1. So in such case, this left index will start pointing to C and right index will start pointing to T. Now again, it will be same, but these character is already swapped. Now we have an exit condition in this case. When left index is less than right index, then we have to exit from this loop. So left index is greater this case. We should be keep checking if it should always be less than to the right index. But here you can see left index value is 4 and right index value is 3. This is exit condition. This is false. So we have to exit from this loop and whatever swap operation we have done, that is output. Now let's compare this this output with the output we are expecting. So output is LEO. I think this should be O only. Yeah. LEO TC EDE. So EDE, it means this output is similar to the output which we are expecting. So this is just an explanation of this program. Now let's get started with the actual program implementation. So we will be creating one private method to check whether a particular character is a vowel or not. So let's create that. Private boolean is vowel, which is expecting input of character. Inside this, we will be checking whether the given character is a vowel or not. So let's create a list of vowels first, and then we will be checking whether the current character is vowel or not. So we have contain method of this collection class, in which it is checking whether a particular object is present in that list of object or not. So if the CH is present in the list of vowels, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So this is a method to verify a given character is vowel or not. Now let's write main method. Let's create a string first, any random string code. And we will be converting this string into character array because we need to apply two pointer approach on character array. So that's the reason we are converting string into character array. Now we will be creating two pointers. One is left pointer index. It will be start pointing from 0th index. The second will be right pointer right index, which will be initially pointing to the last index of array, which is cast.length minus 1. Now we have to use loop here, and the exit condition of this loop will be left index should always be less than right index. If it is false, then the program need to exit from this loop, because at one point left index value will be increased from the right index value the way we have here. Okay, so in that case we should stop iterating and it should exit from the loop. Now we have to handle first use case where the left index and the right index character both are pointing to vowel, this one. First use case, let's create it static to avoid creation of object, is vowels, and let's pass cats of left index first, and is vowel cats of right index. These both are vowel, so if both the index is pointing to vowel, in such case we have to swap these vowels. So swapping is done. Once swapping is done, we will be increasing left index by 1 and decreasing right index by 1. The first use case we already handled. Second use case is else if. If left index is pointing to vowel, only left index. So if vowels cares of left index. If left index is pointing to vowel and right index not, then we have to freeze the left index and decrease the right index by 1. Okay. The third use case is, let me comment this, paste. There should be right index. And this is a third one. So in this scenario, else if is vowel of care of right index. If right index is holding the character that is vowel, then we have to freeze the right index and increase the left index by 1. And in the remaining scenario, when the left index and right index both are not pointing to any of the vowel, right index and left index is not equal to vowels, in this case we will be increasing left index by 1 and right index by 1. Right index we need to decrease it. At the end of the loop we will print this array. That's all, I believe. Anything else is missing? Okay, so this is output, this is input. Okay, let's try running this program. LE, let's compare this basically to save, it will save our time. So LEOTCED, this is expected output. Now let's try with some different input. Hello. So this E and O should be replaced to each other. HO. So this is vowel, this is vowel. So these should be replaced. It should be HOLLE. HOLLE. Okay. What if we won't pass anything? It should also work fine. Okay, it is working fine. These are edge cases, we can handle it while implementation, but the main use cases, we have to swap these vowels to each other if we found any. In other scenario we need to keep it as it is. So it is working as expected, as we verified. So that's it from this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. and stay tuned for another videos. Thank you.